Okay, so this is a tutorial about how to set up an e-commerce website. I did the tutorial, but I forgot to record the audio, so now I'm recording the audio while watching the video. So I was talking about the options, about current options for setting up an e-commerce website. You've got places like I'm gonna have to pause because I'm going too fast. I've also, this was like a 45-minute recording, so I've like sped it up. I sped the video up like twice as fast, so that you get like 45 minutes condensed into 20 minutes, so it goes really fast. So I'm gonna have to try and keep up with the voiceover. So what I was talking about was BigCartel, Shopify, BigCommerce, places like this. They charge you a monthly fee to set up an e-commerce website, but in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how, using WooCommerce and WooThemes, you can get the same professional e-commerce type stuff for free. So, you know, you've got WooThemes, and also we're gonna be looking at some other stuff. So we're gonna go through everything about setting it up. Things that you need to be aware of are, yeah, we're gonna be going from this to this kind of thing, a fully functioning e-commerce website based on WordPress. So it means that you're going to have to know about WordPress, you're going to have to know about domain names, setting up a domain name, setting up hosting, and setting up a WordPress, which is covered in a previous video if you want to check that out. But it does, this video does assume that you know about WordPress. So we got a blank template WordPress in there, and we're going to show you how to get it all set up on a domain. Okay, so WooThemes, they're pretty good templates for WordPress. They give you some free templates. So you go to WooThemes, themes, and then you can see all the themes that are compatible with their WooCommerce e-commerce plugin, which is a free plugin. And there's all different themes to suit different kinds of online e-commerce stores. And the one I like to use is this one, Wootique, because it's nice and minimalist, but really functional. So, I'm going to show you how to set it up on your WordPress. So, you download them, you get these zip files. So we need the theme, Wootique theme, we need WooCommerce, and something called WooDojo, which is another zip file. Then we go to appearance themes, and we go to install theme. Then I was playing some music. Can get quite boring watching me just install themes, but unfortunately, because I've sped up the video like twice the fast, the music just sounds like ridiculous, so I've had to get rid of the music. So it's just installing the theme, activate the theme. Now you go to enhance your theme with WooDojo, which it tells you about. So you just click on that. And then it's a plugin, so you go to plugin, add new plugin, and upload. Get that installed. Upload another one. The WooCommerce one. I'll get the music back on. It's quite a big plugin, so it takes a while to upload. Listen to 8-bit versus dubstep by WubWub Megamix if you're interested. Okay, so then this is what it looks like, art. But it's still too busy for my liking. It's got, I like it super minimal. So what we do is, first of all, we delete all the default posts and pages. We don't want those polluting our website. Then we get rid of all these default widgets. You just grab them and throw them away. Some in appearance widgets. So now it's looking a bit more minimal. Still stuff that I don't like. So we go to editor. I want to get rid of this thing down here. And so we go to footer. Go to editor, footer, we grab this code. Delete it, we update the file. And if we refresh it, we've got rid of that. Now we want to get rid of the... in here it's just repeating like the domain, which I'm not bothered about. I think I messed it up, so I had to pause it and then figure out how to do it. Then we went to Twitter randomly. Still messing up with the code. Oh, but I get it right here. So, what do I do now? I want to get rid of the search bar. So, I have to pause it here because I need to figure out where I go to get rid of the search bar. You go to hit style CSS and just put don't show up there. So now we're talking about we want to customize the site to how we want it. So we want our own logo in there. So if you get a transparent PNG file, and you're gonna have to experiment with the size and stuff until you get it positioned how you want it. But you just upload it, and then it shows your transparent PNG logo there. And there's all these options that you can go through to get the front page looking exactly how you want it. Like, this is how I want it looking. So I want this red color, so I go to background color. I grab the number thing and just paste it in. Then I want all the fonts on the site to be the same font. I want them all to be Myriad Pro. So I just go in and change all the fonts to Myriad Pro. Now if we refresh it, it's looking more like what I envisioned. Now I go to settings and we change the permalinks to this post name so that we're going to create the menu up here. So we go to menu, create a menu name, create a menu. Now we set the primary menu to the menu that we've just created. And now we go to pages. Oh, and now we click this WooCommerce welcome, install WooCommerce pages. We click that, and that's going to give us a load of pages that are relevant to a e-commerce website. And then we enter some custom pages, such as an about page. And because we set the permalinks, we get the permalink is like that. And then we want a contact page. So now we go back to menus, and we can add our contacts and about. We can add our shop page, my account page, and I think that's it. So I add those in, shuffle them around how I want them. Now we've got a menu up here so that people can get on inside. I want to add a home page, so click a home page link, save that. Now we want to sort out the contact page. You can do this by going to pages, go to your contact page, edit, go to template, and go to contact form. But what I want to use is WooFoo. It's an online form builder, which I really like. And this is me trying to figure out how to log in. So, things are fair enough to log in. Alright, so you can make forms really easy in there for free, and then you just get embed code and you just embed them in the text part of your post and save them, and then you get a really nice customizable form with the capture inbuilt so you don't get any spam. So also I want to install a hello bar, which is a little bar at the, which appears at the top of the page, which draws people's attention to important things that you want to draw their attention to. So I, you know, if you've got a mailing list, you could say click here to join it to get free stuff on our mailing list, or you can, what I want to do is draw people's attention to the About Us page. So you get your hello bar, you create your hello bar free, you stick it in your header, the code that they give you, and then you get a nice little bar that appears at the top of your site which draws people's attention to whatever you want that to draw their attention to, which we'll see in a second once I figure out where I'm going to stick the code. So you get this nice little bar at the top, so it's like, you want to know more about us, click here. So I want to take them to the About Us page, because someone coming to the website for the first time, they might be a bit overwhelmed, and this really takes them to where I want to start them out. So we've got that set up. Yeah, I'm just saying that you can't see the hello bar on this because I'm logged into the WordPress, which creates this bar up at the top. So now we can start adding products. So we go to WooCommerce. Oh no, what we need to do is set up our WooCommerce. So we go to WooCommerce settings, and then we can look at all the extensive, sophisticated e-commerce settings that we can control through the WooCommerce. We can set up location, currency, all this stuff. Lots of options to go through. It's best to just go and experiment with yourself. So you go through catalog, you can choose how your catalog is set out, pages, the pages are all set out, inventory, you can control this inventory, you can control tax, stuff, shipping, options, everything that you can get in all these paid e-commerce. So this is what a really important bit is, payment gateways. We want to control how people can pay us. I want to keep it simple, so I just want to keep it to PayPal. I don't want to be dealing with bank transfers and checks, so we can click on these at the top and just disenable them, because I don't want to deal with people sending checks and all this kind of things. I just want people to pay through PayPal. Don't want cash on delivery, so it's just PayPal's just enabled and is the default. So click save. Now, and then you add your PayPal email address, and then anytime anyone orders, the payment will just be automatically sent to your PayPal. You'll be able to manage all the orders through this website. There's integration if you want to add Google Analytics to track people visiting your website. So now we're ready to add products. So we want to create some products. So I just, there was an error in the menu, I did a double HTTP, so I just had to go and fix that. I don't know what I'm talking about here. I'm just saying we've got the layout and the look all set up. Now we just want to add some products. So we've got products, add product. create a product, add the title, add a description, which I get from Wikipedia. Paste that in. Then we can control all this inventory. We can set the price, we can set a sale price, we can schedule a sale, we can set the inventory, we can set the stock status, we can set shipping options. You know, just like any sophisticated e-commerce platform, we can do upsells, cross-sells, all this advanced stuff that's yours to use if you want it to. This is all for free, we're not having to pay any monthly fee. Then what we want to do, we can set a product gallery where we add images. We can add we can categorize the products so that we can group them in the shop so that people can shop by category. It's really simple to do. So you can just create a really sophisticated e-commerce user experience. So we want to set a featured image now, so I pick the Mona Lisa, I pick a really big image which takes ages to upload. So you've got to set featured image. Upload the Mona Lisa, which takes ages. Set it as a featured image. Then, ta-da, our product appears on the page. Then we set it as a featured product, so we go to color visibility and click featured product, click update. And then it appears in our featured product, but I'm complaining because the featured product image is too pixelated and low res, so what we need to do to fix that is go to a plugin. We get regenerate thumbnails, so we go to search for regenerate thumbnail search plugin. And this is me just figuring out what I need to do, and I figured it out. So we go to regenerate thumbnails, install, activate. Then we go to WooCommerce settings catalog, and then we change product thumbnail to 5555555, save changes. And I don't know if you can notice in the video, but you will notice if you do this yourself. You click regenerate thumbnails from settings, then it regenerates thumbnails, and then the thumbnail becomes really high res. I don't know if you can tell from the video, but it does become much better. So now we've got our featured product on the homepage. And I want to add Bitcoin payment option, so I click this. There's a plugin that you can install called Bitcoin Payments WooCommerce. So I upload that, because I'm interested in the idea of people buying art with bitcoins. So I want to have this payment gateway option as well as PayPal. So we activate that plugin, it's all the options. And then if we go to WooCommerce settings, payment gateways, we've now got this bitcoin, and we just need to configure it in order to get it working, but I don't go into that. So now we've got our shop, we've got our product, first product in there, and now I'm saying I want to add a bit of introductory text to the, just underneath the logo. So we go to add new post, and I think in the current options that I've got it set up as the latest post appears up on the front page, so I just use it as a way of having a little introductory text on the front page just to introduce people to the site. So I click publish. So now we've got a little introductory text. We've got feature products, we've got now we want to go to appearance widgets to control our sidebar and get some stuff appearing in the sidebar. So what I want to have in the sidebar is a couple of we accept Bitcoin images. So I go to grab some code that I prepared earlier, click that and paste it in the widget area. Then I want to have some random products pop up underneath that, so I grab this widget, drag it there, title it as, so we stick random products there, save that, and now we've got our sidebar here featuring all this stuff. So I think that's about it really. We've set up, you know, a really sophisticated e-commerce platform where people can come onto the site and buy things and really easily and pay for things, and we can add products and manage products and manage orders and payments and delivery and accept payments in bitcoins and all this stuff all for free, all without having to pay any monthly fees except like basic hosting fees for a website, just not much. So I hope you found that a good introduction to e-commerce tutorial, and I hope you go out and experiment creating your own e-commerce website, and let me know what you get up to with that. So thanks, and I'll see you later. Here we go!